Good evening, everybody, and once again, for the second time tonight, welcome to the Red Zone here at Hicksville High School. The main gymnasium, as we are getting ready for the second of our three live streams that we have scheduled for tonight. It'll be junior varsity boys basketball action as the Hicksville Aces throw out the welcome mat for the visiting Ayersville Pilots here at the Red Zone tonight. Hi, everybody. I'm Bill Murphy with Hicksville Community Television. Alongside Jim Seiler, who'll be calling the play-by-play. Chris Warner operating the iPad Pro camera for us this evening. Glad to have you with us. Want to say a big thank you to all of the underwriters making our coverage possible from here at the Red Zone tonight. Our Diamond Level supporters with us underwriting all of our Aces sports coverage, all sports, all levels, all platforms throughout the entire school year. That's the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships in Hicksville, Ohio. Jim Schmidt Chevrolet Buick, Jim Schmidt Ford, and online at jimschmidtauto.com. APT Manufacturing Solutions of Hicksville, Ohio, located in Hicksville's Industrial Park, and online at aptmfg.com/careers. Our good friends at the Hicksville Pharmacy, your locally owned and operated family independent pharmacy right in the heart of downtown Hicksville. Also, thanks to our Gold Level supporter, Subway of Hicksville, proud supporter of the Subway Player of the Game that we award at the end of each varsity contest we cover during the basketball season. And our Bronze Level supporter, our good friends at the Hicksville Bank, located in the heart of downtown Hicksville, your full service bank, there to help you with all of your family's banking needs. Glad to have you with us. If you are joining us for the first time earlier in the freshman game, it was the Aces winners as they knocked off the Pilots 31-18, the score, final score in the freshman game. They only had five kids playing for them in the freshman game, the Pilots did, and some of them are going to be doing maybe some double duty here tonight as part of the junior varsity squad. And as we count down the last minute, 15 seconds before tip-off, Jim, let's take a look at the starting lineups, and we'll begin with the visiting Ayersville Pilots.
All right, we're ready to go with it. The JV team for Ayersville is coached by former football coach Chris Dales. I guess maybe he is the football coach yet. Anyway, their starting guard is number 0, Caden Brown. He's a junior at 5'8". Number 3, Ray Wolfram, sophomore at 5'10". Number 10, David Amoroso, Ben Amoroso, sophomore at 5'8". Number 20, Garrett Flory, sophomore at 6'2". And number 33, Carter Michelle, sophomore at 6'2". For Hicksville, coached by Dave Blue, they start J.R. Mendoza, junior at 5'11". Number 4, Jaden Rosales, a freshman at 5'7". Number 10, Tatum Sheets, a junior at 6'. Number 11, Braden Slattery, a sophomore at 6'3". And number 21, Braxton Heisler, a freshman at 5'10". So it'll be Slattery going up against Garrett Flory for the jump to start the game. And Ayersville controls.
And we're underway. Glad to have you with us. Hope you enjoy our live coverage tonight here on the HIX-TV YouTube channel.
And the first shot put up by Ayersville is a driving layup missed by Caden Brown. And rebound are caught by the Aces. Rosales had it, gives it to Braxton Heisler, across to J.R. Mendoza, and downtown it's no good. Rebound comes off to Garrett Flory. Ball is up the floor. Flory has it back out on top. Yeah. Number 3 at the point is Ray Wolfram. Pass down low. And shot put up by number 20, Garrett Flory, and he is followed by
Slattery, yep.
Number 11.
Two shots coming up now for Flory. No score yet in this contest. In and out, no good.
Missed them both. The rebound comes off to Wolfram.
You get it out to Brown.
Brown trying to be more athletic than he really is.
Trapped in a double team. And
we're going to have a foul.
10, yep. So that'll be Sheets.
Take some Sheets.
Second team foul.
And Coach Blue is not here tonight.
Yeah, both of the freshman coaches are continuing to coach in the JV game on both sides of the ball here.
Wolfram drives baseline, put up the jumper. It's no good. And Flory gets a rebound. Flory gets another.
And gets
fouled on the floor.
Yep. 21, that'll be on Heisler.
Yep. Aces have three fouls already.
Yep, with just 4 minutes, 38 seconds left to go in the first quarter. So, yeah, we played 2.5 minutes, or a minute and a half. Quick inbounds.
Ball knocked away from Flory and picked up by Sheets. Sheets has the ball.
No.
Taken away by Ambrose. Flory. Ball coming around. Brown with it. Gives it to Wolfram. Wolfram just Flory back around.
Aces.
Ayersville moving the ball really well.
Yep.
33 is Michelle and misses a shot. And
Rosales comes out of it with the ball.
Down to Florida is Tatum Sheets. Gives it up to Heisler. Heisler tries the baseline. Kicks it back out to Mendoza. Sheets in the lane, and he's going to be fouled.
Be on 10. Yep. Amoroso picks up his first personal team foul number one into the game for the Pilots, number 14, Connor Marvin. And also number two, Lucas Fishpaw.
Yep. Another foul. Number two immediately picks up a foul.
Fishpaw. Common foul, so Mendoza will inbounds.
Is it Rosales and misses everything. Saved the ball by Slattery, gets it out to Sheets. To Mendoza, back to Slattery. Rosales. UJR. Ball out. The Heisler trying to go baseline, not able to do it.
Nice save by Rosales. Gets back out. Now Mendoza has it deflected out of bounds.
Rosales with the ball. Corner. Slattery. No good.
No good.
Rebound. Ez. Who is that? Number 33. That's Michelle.
That's Carter Michel. Or Mitchell. Or Michelle.
I don't know.
Or Michael.
Could be. We'll make it Michael.
Get a chance at halftime. We'll go down and we'll double check to make sure. We don't like
yeah.
to, we don't like to mispronounce names, so that one.
It can be.
I'd be tempted to go with Michel, but I don't know.
Heisler up the floor, still controlling
keeps it,
the ball.
Keeps it under control, but not by much, and he gets into
and
a triple team.
Fouled.
They swarmed all over him.
33.
Mitchell or
whatever.
Michael. Michelle.
Rosales with the ball.
Still no score with a minute 50 to go in the first quarter.
No score yet. Mitchell.
Whoa.
Ball knocked out of bounds.
Stuff goes flying all over the scoring table.
Yeah. Whatever that is. Electrical tape. Okay. Okay. They need it down there.
Tape it down.
Brown with the ball. Spins in the lane.
The corner.
Out the corner.
There we go.
And Amoroso
gets the first points of the night as he sinks the three to give the Pilots a 3-0 lead with a minute and 15 seconds left in the first quarter. Oh.
Boy.
Heisler,
Aces layups leave.
Saw him just miss several times in the freshman game. And that one bounced around the rim three or four times. Would not go down for him.
And we're going to have a foul.
21. Heisler again. Two quick ones on Braxton. Four total team fouls on the Aces.
Bronson Graber coming in for Braxton.
Graber was looking pretty good in the freshman game.
Yeah, he was. Brown with it. And we're going to have an over and back call.
So turn it over. Mendoza to handle the inbounds chores for the Aces.
Sheets across the line. Graber to Rosales. Mendoza. 30 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Slattery with it out front over to Mendoza, the Graber, Rosales,
nope.
Rebound, Slattery, Rebound,
once
Slattery,
again, there we go.
Goes. That's what you get, just sticking with it. And at the end of the first quarter of play, it's Ayersville 3 and Aces 2 in the JV game.
One of the lowest scoring first quarters in a junior varsity game I think I've ever
seen,
but that's all right. It's 3-2, and we're going to take some time here between quarters to say thank you to one of our Diamond Level supporters making our coverage possible here on Hicksville Community Television. That's the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships in Hicksville, Ohio. Jim Schmidt Chevrolet Buick, Jim Schmidt Ford, and online at jimschmidtauto.com. If you're in the market for a vehicle, whether you're looking for something brand new or pre-owned, be it a car, truck, van, or SUV, check out the selection they have on the lots, or you can check out the entire dealer inventory online anytime at jimschmidtauto.com. Don't see what you're looking for? Let the folks at Jim Schmidt know what you're interested in. They always do their best to find you exactly the vehicle you want and one that'll best suit you and your family's transportation needs. It's all about service before, during, and after the sale at the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships in Hicksville, Ohio. Jim Schmidt Chevrolet Buick, Jim Schmidt Ford, and online at jimschmidtauto.com. Put 6 minutes on the clock, and we'll get ready for quarter number two here tonight. Again, a low-scoring affair, 3-2 after the first 6 minutes, with the Pilots holding on to that one-point lead.
Mendoza inbounds the ball. Rosales to Mendoza. Over to Graber. Graber, ball knocked away and picked up by Brown.
Sheets.
Stolen away by Sheets. And he gets the lay-in.
Tatum Sheets makes it a 4-3 game. And the Aces take the lead for the first time tonight.
Ball inside, and Mendoza's just.
Maybe on 10, maybe on Sheets.
Can't be on Sheets. He wasn't even standing clear back there. Should have been on Mendoza.
That's what I thought too, but they put 10 on the scoreboard, so yeah. That's what we're going with.
Yes.
That's team foul number 5 on the Aces, by the way.
He even looked up at the clock to see what's the story.
Long bomb is good for 3.
That's Ray Wolfram.
So far, both the all 6 points coming off of 2 3-point shots.
Slattery.
For the Pilots.
Chase it down.
Yep. Out of bounds. Into the game for the Aces, Sanders. Austin Sanders. And also coming back in for the Pilots, number 2, Lucas Fishpaw, as Brown will have a seat.
Fishpaw with it. Out front. Wolfram, 12-footer up, no good. Rebound to
Sanders.
Mendoza up the floor. Graber into the lane. Gives it up to Slattery. Nice pass and couldn't keep it going. Didn't get in front of him enough. Graber. Or Sanders. Sanders drove it.
He'll get the bucket, draw the foul. And that'll be on Amoroso. His second. Team foul number 4 on the Pilots. And Austin Sanders at the line.
Got it.
Makes it a 7-6 game as the Aces retake the lead.
Brown is in for Amoroso. Into the corner. Bringing it out. Sanders, Wolfram, Wolfram to Fishpaw. Fishpaw drives down, 6-footer, up and good.
Good. Lucas Fishpaw. That's their first 2-point bucket of the night. 3:40 to go here in the second quarter. Junior varsity basketball action. Pilots lead the Aces 8-7.
Aces with the ball on the outside. Slattery from the corner. It's
got
good.
It. Makes it a 10-8 game as the Aces go up by a bucket.
Brown with the ball.
Good job
ball
by Slattery.
Ball is off of Marvin.
Yeah.
Somebody break out. We're going to have a timeout.
Yep, Mendoza was having a hard time finding somebody to get the ball to, so before they get the 5-second call, timeout on the floor.
Deal timeout.
10-8, the Aces with the 2-point lead here in the junior varsity game. As we're heading towards halftime. Again, this is the second of 3 live streams we're going to have for you here on the HIX-TV YouTube channel. Got the freshman game in earlier. This is the junior varsity, and when this one wraps up, we'll end this live stream, take a bit of a break. We'll be back with our final live stream, which will be the varsity matchup to wrap up a busy Friday of basketball action here at the Red Zone.
So Aces inbound the ball with 2:50 remaining in the first half. The Mendoza in the corner to Slattery for three again. It's off the rim, and Fishbaugh comes up with it. Gives it up to Wolfram. He traveled.
Yep. You can't jump like that.
You can do it.
Well, you can, but you're going to turn the ball over.
Yeah. Rosales with the ball. Mendoza to Rosales. Slattery inside. It goes to Sheets.
JR.
Ow.
Slattery track. Did he step on the?
Must have.
Yep. Quick whistle. I thought he might have been able to save it, but evidently part of the sneaker was on the red paint, and they blow the whistle. It'll be a turnover back to the Pilots. Fishbaugh inbounds it to Brown. And here comes Ayersville with 2:02 left to go in the half.
Yep.
Almost.
Yeah, almost.
Another almost.
Horseshoes, hand grenades, and atom bombs, almost. Fishbaugh with it to Brown. Across to Wolfram. Wolfram to the free throw lane. Puts up a jumper.
Got it.
12, it's good.
Ray Wolfram, 5 points now for him, and we're tied at 10 with a minute 25 before halftime. Aces with the ball.
Mendoza to Slattery for three. Not
short.
Again.
Saved.
Slattery gets the shot inside.
There
it's
we go.
Good.
Got the roll. Good job, Braden Slattery. Aces up by a bucket again, 12-10. Under a minute to go in the half.
Brown with it. Into the lane. Bounced it off of a foot, and Aces come up with it. Mendoza along the sideline. Pass inside. Over to Rosales on the opposite.
Got it.
We got two.
Wrong two for Jaden Rosales. No, they're going to give him a three, Jim.
You're kidding.
Yeah, they've got his number up there, 3 points.
Well, wonderful.
15 to 10. So.
And I know he put his fingers up, too.
Yeah.
We'll put it down.
Now they've got it back down to 14, so they're going to switch it. Okay. They still got him for 3 points on the one scoreboard, but they changed it from 15-10 to 14-10.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Should be 15. There it went. It's down to two again.
All right. That adds up then. I got 14.
Yeah.
Scoreboard says 14.
Fishbaugh has the ball along the sideline.
Mendoza giving him a hard
12
time.
12 seconds to go. Across, out front.
Driving into the paint. Up.
What's up? The short jumper. It's no good. And that's the end of the first half of play with the Aces JVs on top of Ayersville, 14-10.
So we've reached halftime of the junior varsity game, and it's the homestanding Aces holding on to a four-point lead at the intermission. We want to take some time here to say another big thank you to another one of our Diamond Level supporters helping make our coverage possible here from the Red Zone. That's APT Manufacturing Solutions of Hicksville, Ohio, located in Hicksville's Industrial Park, a world-class facility offering robotic packaging and palleting solutions, welding, powder coating, lots more. You can find out all about the many great things that they do by checking them out online It's APTMFG.com. And they have employment opportunities as well. They're looking to add some people to their team. Maybe you could become a part of the APT family. Log on to aptmfg.com/careers. You can check out the many opportunities that they have. Whether you're looking to start a career, second career, add to the skills you already have, they'd love to hear from you. You can upload your resume, fill out an application right there online. They'd love to hear from you. And we want to thank them so very much for their continued support of our Aces Sports broadcast. Whenever you see Aces Sports action on Hicksville Community Television, whatever the sport, whatever the level of play, from junior high all the way through to varsity, whatever the platform, whether it's SMTA Channel 8, Mediacom Channel 12, Hicksville Community Television Facebook page, or as you're watching right now, the HIX-TV YouTube channel, they're the ones that help make it possible. APT Manufacturing Solutions, located in Hicksville's Industrial Park, and online at aptmfg.com. I want to thank them also. A big thank you to our Bronze Level supporter helping make this coverage possible, the Hicksville Bank, your full-service bank located in the heart of downtown Hicksville. And, of course, Subway of Hicksville, our Gold Level supporter, proud sponsors of the Subway Player of the Game. Jim and I hand that out at the end of each varsity contest we cover during the basketball season here on Hicks TV. So, once again, halftime score, it's the Aces leading the Pilots 14-10. We're going to take a little bit of a break. But Jim and I will be back, and we'll have all the exciting second-half play-by-play coming your way right here on Hicks TV. And, of course, those of you with us on the live stream on the Hicks TV YouTube channel, we're going to keep things going here for halftime. We've got about 7.5 minutes to go before we get the third quarter underway. And, again, this is this is night number one of a big basketball weekend here at the Red Zone. We got back-to-back triple headers. Been a while since we've had that, Jim.
But
three games tonight. And then tomorrow it'll be non-conference action, but it ought to be three pretty good games, too. The Arch Bowl Blue Streaks coming to town.
Yeah.
Especially the varsity matchup ought to be a good one.
So, yeah, they got a stud playing varsity.
Yeah. So we will look forward to that. And just like tonight, we'll have three live streams on Saturday. And the first one will get underway just a little before 4:30 with the freshman game on Saturday afternoon. So we'll look forward to that. And then we'll have Sunday off. Monday we'll have the January school board meeting coming up. And then on Tuesday we'll be back here at the Red Zone with girls JV and varsity basketball action as the Lady Aces will entertain Fayette in a non-conference matchup. So we'll look forward to that. Brian Williams is going to be helping us out running the camera on Saturday. And I think Christopher will be back with us next week on Tuesday for the girls' game. Have to cross-reference with his busy schedule.
Yes, yes. We'll have to check it out.
He's busy updating. He's busy updating the IG right now. So you're not on. You're not up to. Oh, okay. I thought you were updating the Instagram. Oh no, he's playing Pokemon Go. Okay. Well, we are glad to have you with us. Had some fun before the start of the game. Got to go down and give out the. We've been holding on to the Player of the Game certificates and the $10 Subway gift cards from our two nights down at Eden for the Route 49 Classic. It was Josh Myers got the Player of the Game award for his efforts in the opening round on Monday night. And then Tuesday we got snowed out, which it was just kind of odd. It hasn't, I mean, You know the roads had to be pretty, and they were in really bad shape. I mean, the snow did not last long, but for about the 2 hours that it came down, I mean, it really, really came down.
Those were the biggest flakes I've seen in a long time.
And I was talking with some of the people at the village, and they came out and admitted, they said, you know, it really wasn't that cold or anything like that. It was just the snow came down so fast. It just overcame the warm temperatures, and it was coming down faster than the trucks could clear it. And so they just said, so it was just, there was just nothing you could do. I mean, they had the trucks out and they were working, they were treating the roads. It was just coming down so fast, it didn't matter. So So it might have seemed odd that they get snowed out because, on you know, by 7 o'clock, everything was fine.
Right.
So
well, at 7 o'clock after the game was canceled, I went to Defiance.
Yeah. So, like I said, it was just one of those odd nights, and then they rescheduled the championship and consolation games for Thursday, the 30th. And you had a conflict because you had a family thing on the 30th.
Yeah, we had family Christmas.
Yeah, so Christopher and I went down and did the second night and had a good time. Again, hats off to A.D. Ripke at Eaton. It was just really nice. He had a really great setup for us and all of the media people and they had had a little cooler for every media station that had some water and some sodas or candy bars, a little something each night, and really appreciate that. That's really kind of nice, and again, just a really, really well-run tournament. And again, the player of the game, the Aces played in the consolation game on the 30th, and the player of the game was Alex Gordon, who came in when Jackson Bergman got into some foul troubles, and Jackson was coming in and out, and they moved Alex Gordon in, and Gordon just picked it right up. I mean, there was like, so I think Bergman wound up with like 12 or 13 points, whatever, but Gordon had like 9. So, wow. I mean, it was just, you know. So Myers and Gordon were the players of the game for the two nights of the Route 49 Classic, so we were able to get them their $10 Subway gift cards and their certificates before the start of the JV game here tonight. So if you see the photograph, I'm the short guy in the middle. I'm the little guy. but congratulations to both of them. And again, we'll be giving out another gift card to another player of the game after the end of the varsity contest coming up a little bit later here this evening. And we should probably tally up some unofficial scores here too real quick. Michael? Okay. So we were right. Carter Michael. So Jim was right about that one.
What?
I said Jim was right about the pronunciation of Michael, and Warner's like, well, he's always right. You know?
He's got it.
There we go.
Tell my wife that.
Yeah.
Whoa. Nah, she's at Antwerp.
Striker at Antwerp tonight?
Fairview.
Fairview, okay.
Yeah.
There you go. Welcome back, everybody. We're a little over a minute away from getting the third quarter underway here at the Red Zone. And as we get ready to tip off quarter number three, let's take a look at the unofficial scores from the first half of play. Again, if you're just joining us at halftime, it's the Aces leading the Ayersville Pilots in this junior varsity game by 4, 14-10, the halftime score. Now, for the Pilots, the scoring looks like this unofficially. They were led in scoring in that first half by Ray Wolfram. Wolfram had a three-pointer and a bucket for two and a total of 5 points unofficially. After that, Ben Amorosa with a three-pointer for three and a bucket and two for Lucas Fishpaw. And that adds up to 10, and that accounts for the 10 points on the scoreboard for the Pilots.
For Hicksville, they have Austin Sanders had a basket and a free throw for three. Jaden Rosales had a bucket for two. Tatum Sheets had a bucket for two. And Braden Slattery had a triple and two baskets for seven.
Yep, that tallies with what I have, too.
So comes up with 14.
So Ayersville will have the ball inbounds to start the third quarter. And once again with the play-by-play, here's Jim Seiler.
Okay. Have Caden Brown with the ball. I see his grandpa is here tonight. Oh, you just ran all over the floor.
Little extra step there.
Yep. Carter Michelle took a trip.
So Heisler back on the floor now. Braxton playing with two fouls.
Yeah. JR gets the ball up. Slattery has it across the other side. Ooh, JR. Mendoza on the point. Gives the ball. Is that Langham out there now? JR in the lane, pass down intended for Sheets, and it's knocked out of bounds. Yep.
I think that was Flory that got his hand in there.
Braxton short with the shot. Oh, JR with the foul.
Yep. So Mendoza will pick up his first. And that'll be team foul number one for the Aces in the second half. Inbounds to Brown.
That Wolfram drives the baseline.
Looking for some
trapped
help.
Down low, put up a shot.
Michael follows it up and gets it.
And gets it.
Carter Michael, his first points of the night. Held him scoreless in the first half.
Holy cow. Caden Brown retrieves the ball, brings it back. We're back to Wolfram. Wolfram driving on Heisler. Outside is Amoroso.
Got it.
Got a three.
That's two trays now for Ben Amoroso. And again, a timeout because Mendoza couldn't find anybody to get the ball inbounds to.
Yep. So the Pilots now lead 15-14 with their Aces timeout.
Yep. So far, Aces have been outscored 5-0 here early on. I want to say a big thank you to the Subway of Hicksville, a great place to stop before or after the game, for their gold-level support and the sponsorship of the Subway Player of the Game at the end of each varsity contest that we cover for the basketball season, both boys and girls. Jim and I select a Subway Player of the Game. They receive a $10 gift card from Subway of Hicksville, a nice certificate they can frame if they want to, or make into a paper airplane or something, I guess. But we appreciate that. I'm not, you know, I designed them, so I guess I can. But we want to thank Al and the gang at Subway. They remind you to download the app to your mobile device. Take advantage of curbside delivery. You can order ahead. They'll have their sandwiches waiting for you to pick up. Want to thank them so very much for their continued support and their sponsorship. The Subway Player of the Game from Subway of Hicksville. Deflected right back to Mendoza.
Yep. He's across the line and down. Gives the ball into Heisler. Back to Mendoza. Mendoza to Sheets. Sheets spins. Gives it back to Langham.
Langham in the game.
Yes. Mendoza drives down inside.
Up
gets
the
bucket.
Mendoza puts the Aces back up by a point, 16-15.
Wolfram with it. At the free throw line, missed down low.
Shot up, in
Amoroso
out.
Shot is no good.
Michael.
Rebound, Michael gets the rebound and scores. 4 points for him.
And that makes it 17-16 as the, whoa. It was Ray Wolfram getting ready to come over and have a seat on the other side of the scoring table there.
Yes.
Out of bounds, back to the Aces. Trail by one.
Langham gives it to Heisler. Heisler spins. 10-footer.
Nope.
No good.
Too high off the glass that
up
time.
The floor. Michael. And it's no good.
No good. But he's going to shoot two. I think Mendoza's going to pick that one up. Yep. Second personal on J.R. Mendoza. Team foul number two on the Aces for the second half. Michael gets the first one.
Missed the second, and a rebound is to Sheets. Mendoza up the floor.
18-16 now, a two-point lead for the Pilots.
Langham in the lane, over to Heisler. Heisler down to Langham, baseline, good.
Good, that'll tie it up.
Brown with the ball, to Amoroso. Wolfram with it. To Brown. Brown spins. To Wolfram. In the corner to Michael. Baseline. No good.
Good. But he'll draw another foul. That'll be another one on Mendoza.
Three times.
Three on JR now. Team foul number three on the Aces. Got it. 19-18 as the Pilots retake the lead by a point. Heisler will step out.
Sanders in the game. Michaels, next shot is also good.
Three out of four.
Slattery to Mendoza. Up the floor we come to Slattery. Back to Mendoza, and it's knocked out of bounds by Michael. It's too bad, you gotta stay there.
Yep. That went right into the lap of Lindsey Bergman.
Fishbaugh. Yep, he's back at it. Making him mad again.
Yep, we have the same officiating crew as was in the freshman game. And there was some, at times eventful freshman game.
Yes. 33, Michael.
That'll be his second. And that's team foul number one on the Pilots. Comes with a minute 58 to go.
Sanders at the line.
Sanders, team down by two.
Good.
Gets the first one. Makes it a one-point game again.
Gets them both. And it's tied. At 20. Amoroso up the floor, Mendoza on him, to Fishbaugh. Fishbaugh working the side, gives it to Brown. Brown, Michael, stolen
away
by Slattery.
Nice feed.
Yeah,
there.
Nice. Sheets gets a bucket.
Gives Slattery an assist on that one.
Yes.
22-20, Aces back on top.
Sanders on Fishbaugh. Amoroso. Brown into the lane, blocked by Slattery. That was beautiful.
Mendoza winds up with it for the Aces. Up by two, chance to build onto that lead.
Slattery from the corner.
Too short.
It's no good.
Nope. Put back.
Michael with her put back. It's no good. And again. And there's a foul.
Sheets picks up his third personal. Team foul number four on the Aces. And two more shots for Carter Michael. He's a pretty good free throw shooter. I got him down four out of five.
You're right. Short on that one.
Yeah.
Sanders with the rebound.
Aces hang on to a one-point lead.
Mendoza in the lane. He traveled.
No, they didn't. They fouled him.
Yeah. 20.
20. That'll Flory. Be Flory. Team, it's his first personal team foul number two on the Pilots. JR got it. Aces need to hit their free throws here.
You're right. Because Ayersville is hitting theirs.
Yep. Got them both.
Four points for Mendoza.
Yeah, 24-21. Aces go up by three with 35 seconds left in the third quarter.
Amoroso turns, lays it in. Yep. 8 points for him.
Mendoza in some trouble. And timeout called by Coach Deal. Aces with a one-point lead, 17.1 seconds to go in the third quarter.
The guy, official definitely wants to know, want you to know who's in charge.
Yeah. Aces, 24-23 Aces with the one-point lead here in the junior varsity game. Well, at least he didn't throw any technicals so far. So we had a technical foul on the coaches on the bench of the Aces in the freshman game. And now we've got some
quick trigger
biological material on the floor. There we go. Clean as a whistle. And Coach Deal's expression says it all.
Yes. It really did.
Ooh, the press works. And Michael capitalizes to put the Pilots up by a point.
He's got 10.
Nope.
Score after three periods of play. It's Ayersville 25 and the Aces 24.
So we'll look forward to it. It might be a wild and woolly fourth quarter coming up here. And while we've got some time, I want to say another big thank you to our another one of our Diamond Level supporters, and that's, of course, the Hicksville Pharmacy, located right in the heart of downtown Hicksville. Locally owned and operated, your family independent pharmacy in Hicksville. There to serve you and your family's pharmaceutical needs. They also have medical equipment available, as well as over-the-counter medications. Lots of great advice. And a nice little store, too, with gifts, Ohio State, Michigan merchandise, greeting cards, candles, you name it. Terrific place. Wouldn't be the same in downtown Hicksville without them. We want to thank the Myers family so very much for their Diamond Level support, helping to underwrite all of our Aces sports coverage on Hicksville Community Television. Again, your locally owned and operated family independent pharmacy in the heart of downtown Hicksville, the Hicksville Pharmacy.
Well, Michael will not be back on the floor in the fourth quarter. He just went to the locker room.
Saving some playing time for the varsity game, I'm guessing. He's a sophomore, but 6'2", so.
Yeah, they got several guys, 6'2", and then they were 1'6".
Yeah, that's
Schlachter,
yeah. Long bomb, nope. Rebound to the Pilots. From behind the backboard, no good.
And he's on his back.
Volleyballing it around. Is that blue three?
Yep, Wolfram.
Wolfram's first. Team foul number three on the Pilots, and the Aces will get the ball back. They're trailing by a point with 5:36 to go here in the JV game. Right back to Rosales.
Offensive foul. Heisler.
Braxton, that's his third. So So Mendoza, Sheets, and Heisler, all with three personals hanging on them now for the Aces. Slattery
nice
controls
hands.
It. Nice.
Nice hand.
I thought he was going to lose that out of bounds
I
on the baseline.
Too. Rosales with the ball, spins in the lane, puts it up, and good.
Nice.
4 points for Rosales.
Yep. Rosales played in the first quarter. We didn't see him at all in the second quarter, and we didn't see him at all in the third. So he'll have some eligibility left
yes.
for the varsity game, too, if they need him.
Yes, he will. Going to pump a three. And
no.
It's over the backboard.
Pilots ball trailing by 126-25. Fishpaw will come in, and having a seat will be Marvin for Ayersville.
Now Amoroso with the ball.
Amoroso's their three-point man.
Brown with it, baseline, puts up a runner, it's no good. Rebound. Brown smartly bounces the ball off an ace leg.
Pilots get the ball inbounds.
Fishpaw with it. Yeah. To Amoroso, back to Fishpaw. Gives it to Brown. Out on the point. Amoroso. Heisler on him. Over to Fishbaugh.
Ooh.
And it's good for three.
Lucas Fishbaugh dials up long distance and makes it a 2-point game in favor of the Pilots, 28-26.
Just under 4 minutes to rim.
3 minutes. 59 seconds to go here. So we're not done yet. This one's going to go down. I think this one may well go down right to the wire.
Yep, at the rate it's going.
Yeah, not surprising. Again, this is inter-county rivalry and a GMC matchup. So a lot going. Both these squads want to get the new year and the Green Meadows Conference season off to a good start. So again, 3:59 to go here. It'll be Aces ball out of bounds on the baseline. Rosales will handle the inbounds chores. They need to turn off the music. There we go. Rosales to Mendoza.
Get it up the floor.
They've got the pressure turned on, and it works. It turns it over.
Amoroso holding the ball. Gives it out to Fishpaw from the corner. It's no good.
No good. Off the iron, though. Nobody there to rebound.
Wolfram with the rebound. Amoroso has it now.
Pilots up by two.
Fishpaw drives and kicks it back out. Amoroso shot is no good, and Slattery comes away with it. To Rosales. Heisler.
Sheets. Nope.
Sheets picks up another foul.
And that'll be four on Tatum. Team foul number six on the Aces, so next one will send the Pilots to the line in the bonus. 2:56 to go here in this junior varsity game.
Fishpaw with it into the lane, out Brown. Brown
pass
down low.
That'll be another foul. That's on Mendoza. That'll be his fourth. And that's team foul number seven. So into the bonus go the Pilots for the remainder of the game. 2:34 left in the fourth quarter. This will be a two-shot foul, I believe, for Wolfram. Got it. ...29-26 Ayersville. Got them both.
Well, with the fouls now, this could open this game right up.
Rosales gets it knocked out of bounds by Amoroso, so it'll stay with the Aces.
Sheets. Heisler knocks it away from him.
That was a nice play by Heisler.
Wolfram out to Brown. I don't think Brown's taking a shot all night.
Go below 2 minutes here.
Now he has.
There we go. Up and no good. Loose on the floor, jump ball. There have not been many of those tonight in this game.
Timeout Blue.
So the Pilots will take a timeout here. They're leading by 4, 30-26. We get ready to head down the stretch run. Full 1 minute timeout. Again, the Ayersville Pilots are in the bonus. The Aces have committed 17 fouls, and the Aces have a couple of players with four fouls each. That's Mendoza and Tatum Sheets. So either of those guys commit another infraction, they're done for the night. And Braxton Heisler not far behind. He's got three personals hanging around his neck. Over on the Pilots side, they have a couple guys with two, Amorosa and Michael. Michael's already out of the game.
Yep.
So they really don't have much to worry about. They've only committed three team fouls here in the second half, so they have got plenty of fouls to give if they want to. So they're in kind of a good position being in the bonus, and with the fouls to give, you maybe want to give a little bit of an advantage to the Pilots here, but if the Aces were to get hot from the field, they could erase that deficit very quickly.
Yep. And we're going to have a foul. That Sheets just picked it up.
And he's done. So Tatum Sheets will foul out with a minute 49 to go in the game with 4 points unofficially to his credit. Heisler back out onto the floor now, and so is Langham. And this is Flory at the line. Got it. That's Flory's first point of the night. Comes at an opportune time for the Pilots.
In and out. Heisler with the rebound.
Heisler flirting with the travel there, but gets it to Rosales.
In the corner to Mendoza. That's up the runner. It's good.
Ooh, nice. 6 points now for JR, and he'll go to the line to see if he can complete the three-point play.
And Amoroso.
Yeah, that's his third. Minute 35. Mendoza misses.
No good.
So it's still a three-point game. Blocked, and JR comes up with it for the Aces. Three-pointer will tie it.
Langham, to move JR. To Rosales.
Go under a minute.
Langham with it. Got to get a shot, gang. There it is.
Got it. Rosales ties it. 31-31.
40 seconds remaining.
Pilots. So timeout on the floor. It's a 31 all game. 31-31. Full 1 minute timeout. Ayersville will have the ball. And they can be a little bit cagey, Jim, because if they can draw the foul,
yes,
they can be aggressive, and if they can draw the foul, they go to the line.
Yeah, they just take it to the hoop, and they'll get fouled.
Yep. And on the other side, if they lose the ball or whatever, they can sort of foul the Aces,
right,
to disrupt their offense,
yep,
and have
all
to
the way down the floor.
Yeah, and make them have to just reset and take it out of bounds. So,
yeah, they could use clock. You know, burn,
yep,
the clock up.
And unfortunately, so far, the Pilots have been pretty good from the free throw line, so there's not like somebody you could identify as a good person to foul to have a decent chance of having them miss the free throws and be able to get the ball back.
Yeah, right.
Fishpaw will get it inbounds to Amoroso, and here we go. Under 30 seconds.
On the outside, Amoroso to Fishpaw, back to Amoroso. To Brown. Amoroso holding it. Rosales on him. Bounce pass. Back door. It's good.
Got it.
Brown with the 2 points. That's his first two of the night.
It's going to be short. Oh, boy. So that's going to wrap up the junior varsity contest for tonight, and it is a whisker-thin victory for the Ayersville Pilots. They knock off the Aces 33-31 on a Caden Brown bucket with about 8 seconds left in the game. Rosales not able to answer on the other end of the floor, so the Pilots pick up the 2-point win here tonight. Do some quick tabulations and get you some unofficial scoring here. Let's get going here so we can wrap this one up and get ready for varsity action tonight. For the Aces on the short end of the scoreboard, their 31 points broke down this way. A couple Aces putting 7 points in tonight. That would be Jaden Rosales. Rosales had a couple of buckets and a three-pointer for 7. And also Braden Slattery. Slattery had a 3 and a couple of 2s for 7 points as well. 6 points tonight for Austin Sanders. Sanders with a couple of buckets and a couple of free throws for his 6. 5 points this evening for Austin Sanders on a bucket and 3 free throws. 4 points for Tatum Sheets before he fouled out. A couple of field goals and a bucket and 2 for Brant Langham tonight.
For the Pilots, it was Caden Brown with the winning layup. That's only 2 points of the night. Lucas Fishbaugh had a bucket and a tray for 5. Ray Wolfram had a bucket and a tray and 2 free throws for 7. Ben Amoroso had 2 trays and a bucket for 8. Garrett Flory, 1 free throw. And Carter Mitchell.
Michael.
Yeah, Michael. 2, 4, 6. Had 3 baskets and 4 free throws and 6 attempts. For 10 points for their total of 33. They were 7 of 12 at the free throw line, and the Aces were 5 of 6 at the line. So free throws were the difference.
Yes, indeed. And again, Michael, the only player in double figures in the game on either side of the ball.
Yep.
So, again, congratulations to the Pilots. They win the JV game by a bucket, 33-31, the final score. And with that, we're going to wrap things up. We're going to take about a 15-minute or so break, and we'll be back with our third and final live stream of this Friday, and that'll be the varsity matchup between the Pilots and the Aces. In the interim, though, we want to say another big thank you to the Hicksville Athletic Department, Mr. Overmeyer and Hott, for giving us the space and permission to live stream the coverage here tonight. We thank them so very much. Thanks also to all of our underwriters making our coverage possible, our Diamond Level supporters, the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships in Hicksville, Ohio, APT Manufacturing Solutions of Hicksville, Ohio, the Hicksville Pharmacy, our Gold Level supporter, the Subway of Hicksville, and our Bronze Level supporter and underwriters, that's the Hicksville Bank, located in the heart downtown Hicksville. Thanks to all of them, and thanks to all of you for joining us. Hope you enjoyed the live stream coverage here on the Hicksville Community Television YouTube channel. That's going to do it for right now, but again, we're going to be back in about 13, 14 minutes or so from right now with varsity action for you here on the Hicks TV YouTube channel. And until then, for Jim Seiler calling the play-by-play and Chris Warner operating the iPad Pro camera, I'm Bill Murphy, Hicksville Community Television, wishing you a good night and good sports.